No, I want to say this. My name is Miguel Ceballos. I'm going to talk about ethical hacking. But first, I want to share a news with you. February 15, 2012 in India, some hackers steal data from Microsoft's online store in India. Then, what they have found was remarkable. They have found unencrypted data. That data includes username and passwords. They can use that information to launch a spear phishing attack. But first of all, what is a hacker? Well, according to Merriam-Webster dictionary, a hacker is a person that is inexperienced or unskilled at a particular activity. For instance, tennis, soccer. If you enjoy to play tennis or soccer and you are looking for better way to improve your practice, then you are a hacker. There's no other word for that. And now, with computers and media, cinema, the word has different meanings. According to Webster's New World Dictionary, the word hacker has two meanings, positive meaning and negative meaning. In the positive one, a hacker is a person that enjoys life to learn about computer systems, networks, and try to improve them and do different things with them. In the negative way of that word, hacker is a person who likes to exploit systems in order to steal data, to damage systems, or to do evil just for fun or just because he can. Okay? And people used to classify hackers according to early Western movies. Bad guys wear black hats, and the good guys wear white hats. In this area for hackers, then, the white hat hackers are computer security specialists that use their skills and abilities to protect systems and networks. And they always do this by a contract with his customer and with permission. Without that, they won't do that. And the bad hacker is the evil hacker, also named cracker, that is the right word for that. The meaning of cracker is criminal hacker. That was good for that. These people use the ability to steal data and all the things that I have said before. And then we have another classification that is gray hat hackers. These hackers act for defensively or offensive or arrest, depending on the money or depending on if they are in the mood or not. Depends on very many other things. And we have another type of hacker. This is the suicide hacker. These are persons who aim to bring down critical infrastructure used to launch a message used for a cause, and they don't worry about if they spend 30 years in jail because of these reasons. And then, why is it necessary to have ethical hacking? Well, actually, there's a certification. You can certify a certified ethical hacker by the EC Council, the Electronic Commerce Council. This certification runs in India. And according to them, this is necessary because we can have tools to test our systems or networks, but they are useful because hackers are very skilled and they have many ways to get into the networks and systems. For the reason we need creative thinking, and an ethical hacker needs to have that creative thinking and need to prevent attacks and also to attack the system in order to know how hackers will get into the system. For this reason, ethical hacking is good, and if you want, you can be an ethical hacker and be in the right side. Okay? Thank you so much for your attention.